It is time for the numerology and the astrology for 12/21/2020, winter solstice 2020, the conjunction between Saturn and Jupiter at 0 degrees of Aquarius. Woo, woo, woo. I am so happy we are finally here. Ugh, it's so good. Anyway, let's start with the numerology. If you add all those numbers together, surprise, surprise, you get the number 10. The number of new beginnings, the number of radiance and light, the number of power and authority, the number of monumental change, the number of stepping up and stepping in. So, not only are we at a major moment astrologically, the solstice and Saturn and Jupiter at 0 degrees of Aquarius, but in the numerology, we are at the new beginning moment where we are asked to hold truth in a highly sacred way. The greatest power comes from holding truth in the most honored of ways and refusing to let bias and opinion destroy those things that were done in pure love and compassion. There is great power in letting in the things that have been done with positive intent and pure love. Okay, have to talk about that couple of statements for a minute. There are people out there that are spending enormous amounts of time and energy and effort and positive intent to bring the highest vibrations and translations of truth from ancient texts and bring them into modern times. And while you can fault people for, maybe you disagreeing with what their assumptions are, maybe at times, it's a really about the intent with something with which something is done. I am like a hound dog. I'm like my nose is like a sniffer to the intention in words. And maybe it's because I'm a writer, and maybe it's because I'm an editor, and maybe it's because I really listen to what is going on underneath the words. Like, you know, am I being dragged along? Is somebody trying to hook my nose with a ring and drag me into a particular area so that I go into agreement with them? Okay. And there are other people out there, especially right now, whose intent is to deceive. Their intent is to lie. Their intent is to confuse. Their intent is to create chaos, and they believe that that gives them power. And while it might give them power on a short-term level, the complete disregard of intent and intention with what you're doing means that they have disconnected from their heart. So it's all in their head. So like they're like it's like they're cut off from here, you know. So they're just speaking and thinking, and they're not feeling, and they're not being, and they're not embodying. And so if something is too mental, too heady, and I'm not talking about philosophers, because philosophers can get very heady, and I you know, love reading Buddhist philosophy, that most people would go like, what the hell does that mean? Like, what are they talking about, Suzanne? And I understand that, because it's about this pure-hearted intent that's coming through as we're trying to express these very esoteric spiritual principles that are connecting everything. But when the intent is to tear apart, tear down, break down, destroy, create hate, create venom, create toxicity, it's just not cool to me, you know. And like I said, I have like a nose for things that are doing that. And what's even more frustrating is I have a nose for it even when it's secondhand or third hand, which means that this person believed that person over there, and so they really believe it. So now they're speaking secondhand and third hand, but the words that come out of their mouth, they don't feel even like the person. They don't even feel authentic. They don't even feel real. They feel distorted. They feel like, who the hell is talking? Who the hell is talking? Like, I don't think that's you. And it feels disingenuous. So I want everybody to start to notice that. Because I will give everybody a lot of flexibility and leeway if their intent is positive, even if their words are skewy. I mean, I get that. I mean, like, we all fall for it at some point. But when you're hooked by the negativity, or hooked by the fear, or hooked by the rage, or hooked by the venom, or hooked by, I mean, you've been basically taken over. It's like a parasite has taken over your mouth. And all of a sudden, this stuff starts spewing out. And I think we so have to start noticing that. Okay, getting off the soapbox now. Okay. The astrology today. Winter solstice is happening at 2:03 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. It's the middle of the night. The moon's position now brings a challenge to individuals, and just know that it may crimp creative expression. The moon is in Pisces, asking us to go beyond the veils of this world and find a way to bring mankind back from the brink of horror and back to sanity. Let us move towards a new and higher vision for this planet. Why is that so bad? In the afternoon, the moon moves into Aries, which stimulates our pioneering instincts to go off trail and to cut a new path in our life. If we noticed a feeling that seems a bit odd or off for the past few days, that is because it is not a normal winter solstice by any stretch of the imagination. As I have reminded everybody for months, you know, today, Jupiter and Saturn align at 0 degrees of Aquarius, and an extremely rare and powerfully transformational event is happening. It marks the end of an era, and the beginning of a new one. Remember this moment. It will be a great story to share later in your life. Where were you when Jupiter and Saturn conjuncted? Do you remember? It's kind of like those major events in your life, okay? Jupiter finally escapes the clutches of the cold, bitter, and dry sign of Capricorn and moves into the progressive and modern sign of Aquarius. Saturn also becomes less serious and heavy as it can finally get to work doing something that has real meaning in the world rather than just wasting its time rehashing the fears and projections of humanity's past. Aquarius is naturally positive and hopeful as it looks ahead to the future. It intends to hold humanity to a higher ideal and then works to bring it actively into the present reality. But all signs have a negative side also. In this position, Aquarius thinks it knows better than everyone else and can get hard-headed and inflexible. So let's not do that either. In the coming 3 months, we will see rapid innovation, and the previous old ideals are revealed as antiquated and toxic. There has been a pervasive feeling of being dazed or confused. Trust me, I've been listening to clients for weeks. It's like, everybody is like, oh my God, what the hell is going on, right? We get to blame Neptune for this murky emotional reality, not to mention the conjunction and the solstice. And, you know, there's a lot of stuff going on, but I'm going to blame Neptune for this one. This watery and planet has been challenging the spiritual destiny nodes of the moon. And the feeling of being confined seems to play prominently in our mind more than before. We can feel this desire to understand why this is and how we can allow our soul to break free of the confines of this pandemic. The best aspect from all of this is that it challenges all of us to find compassion and forgiveness for ourselves and others. We are in the darkest time of the year in the sign of Capricorn. Responsibilities loom large, and there is a strong desire for the rules of law and order to prevail. As we all are influenced by this respectful sign, know that the hard line that Capricorn draws will hold, even in the face of mayhem and those that intend to breed chaos. Capricorn does not mind being uncomfortable. It is the sign of limits and boundaries. By the end of this Capricornian cycle, you will appreciate the surety that this sign defines. It is interesting to me that Capricorn is guarding all the gates before the inauguration. Today you will see the world is looking towards manifesting much more concrete actions, and that technology is going to restructure our world. While some may want to make a lot out of nothing, the power of this astrology keeps holding the line that is clearly moving towards growth, innovation, technology developments, and causes that require immediate assistance. My quote for today: hate leads mankind down a twisted path. Fear defends those whose intention is wrath. Hope leads hearts in truth and light. Kindness defends others because it knows wrong from right. And my blog for today: I look at the history of humanity and it cannot help but sadden anyone that really looks at it. How many atrocities have been perpetuated and condoned in the name of religion, beliefs, superstitions, fear, and hate for those that are different? I believe that the only way to deal with this repeated historical horror is to forcefully speak out against anyone who targets others for any reason that is baseless, slanted towards opinion, or seen and revealed as intentional targeting to make others a victim to make them feel stronger. It is about refusing to tolerate it anymore, and I personally will do just that. That is the only way humanity can evolve safely and progress forward. Hate leads to fear, and fear leads mankind down a torturous path of karmic suffering, and it pulls mankind back into the painful loops of historical atrocities. I'm just done with such things. I am completely sick and tired of all of it. It is a loop of misery continuously perpetuated by those that are ignorant and uneducated. And those two things are also no excuse anymore. None. In this modern day and age, mankind cannot use ignorance or lack of education as a reason for terrible behavior or actions intended to hurt and cause more suffering on the planet. Okay, I'm calming down now. Okay. All right. Okay. Thanks. Bye.